Surah Al-Ma'un, inshallah, it will be also very quick. Surah Al-Ma'un, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدعو اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون الذين هم يراؤون ويمنعون الماعون. Have you seen the one who denies the final judgment? That is the one who repulses the orphan and does not encourage the feeding of the poor. So woe to those hypocrites who pray, yet are unmindful of their prayers, those who only show off and refuse to give even the simplest aid. Surah Al-Ma'un, or the simplest aid. Ma'un means something that you give to someone to aid him or to assist him. Anything that people ask their neighbors for to use and get it back, this is called al-ma'un. Anything that will be helpful to your neighbor and he or she comes to ask to borrow it for some time is called al-ma'un. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يُكَذِّبُ بِالدِّينِ أَرَأَيْتَ يَا مُحَمَّدْ مَنْ يُكَذِّبُ بِالْجَزَاءِ وَالثَّوَابِ وَالْعِقَابِ فَلَا يُطِيعُ اللَّهُ فِي مَا أَمَرَهُ وَلَا فِي مَا نَهَى عَنْهُ. Have you seen, O Muhammad, the one who denies? Ad-Din means the day of judgment. Ad-Din is the day of judgment, or the day of the reward, the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give those who did good reward, and those who did evil will go to Jahannam. So this is called Yawm al-Din. When we read in Al-Fatiha and say, Maliki Yawm al-Din, the owner of the day of judgment. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, have you seen the one who denies the final day of judgment? And then, who is that one? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes him in the next ayah. فَذَٰلِكَ الَّذِي يَدُعُّ الْيَتِيمِ. That is the one who repulses the orphan. فَهُوَ الَّذِي يَقْهَرُ الْيَتِيمُ وَيَظْلِمُهُ حَقَّهُ وَيَدْفَعُهُ دَفْعًا عَنِيفًا ويزجره زجرا قبيحا ولا يطعمه ولا يحسن اليه ولا يحث غيره من ذوي اليسار على اطعام المحتاج بل يبخل بسعيه عند الاغنياء لاغاثه البؤساء كما قال الله تعالى كلا بل لا تكرمون اليتيم ولا تحاضون على طعام المسكين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about that one who denies the day of judgment. And he is saying, this is the one who always does not help al-yateem, the orphan. And then, وَلَا يَحُضُّ عَلَىٰ طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينَ. Not only that he repulses the orphan, he doesn't encourage others to feed the poor. He does not encourage others to feed the poor. We just have to focus for maybe 5-10 minutes, inshallah, I will make it quick. But also this surah has as many pieces of wisdom inside of it. It is a short surah, Surah Al-Ma'un. But also if we focus, we will get great benefit, inshallah, from it. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, asking him and saying, have you seen the one who denies the day of judgment? Who is that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, it is the one who repulses the orphan, who does not give to the orphan, who is not good to the orphan. And also again, وَلَا يَحُضُّ عَلَىٰ طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ. He does not even encourage others to give to the poor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said this in Surah Al-Fajr, كَلَّا بَلْ لَا تُكْرِمُونَ الْيَتِيمِ وَلَا تَحَاضُّونَ عَلَىٰ طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ. That you don't honor the orphan and you don't encourage each other to feed the needy. So the problem here is this punishment and the place in Jahannam that we will talk about by the end of the surah will be for that one who does not encourage others or other people to give to the needy. So what about the one who has money and he doesn't give? Look at this. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned something small and Allah gives it a kind of punishment, you think about the bigger picture. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, the one who does not believe in the day of judgment is the one who does not help the yatim, the orphan, does not give him. And also he is the one who doesn't encourage others to give. So for example, I am not having enough money, but I know some well-off brothers and sisters who can give and donate. So when I see a needy man or woman, I go to these friends and say, do you know what? This man or this woman, they need money, they are very poor. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, the one who doesn't believe in the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah of judgment is the one who does not encourage others to give to the needy. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also explains this in many ayat in the Quran, as we said in Surah Al-Fajr. And then بين الله أن الفقير حق في مال الغني فقال والذين في أموالهم حق معلوم للسائل والمحروم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has indicated many times in the Quran that the poor has a right in the rich's wealth. It is not an option for the rich not to give out from his or her wealth. It is a right that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made for the rich people to give to the poor. So imagine if we do not give that right out, it will be a catastrophic end for us in the hereafter, as he subhanahu wa ta'ala explains. فَلَوْ تَرَكَ الْإِطْعَامِ مَعَ الْقُدْرَةِ كَانَ مِمَّنْ كَذَّبَ بِمَا جَاءَ بِهِ مُحَمَّدْ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمُ. Whoever leaves feeding the poor and he or she can, he or she will be denying the Quran and the Sunnah and whatever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came up with. If we don't give to the yatim, and even if we do not encourage the will of ones to give to the poor, if we don't have, we will be among those who do not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لأن الله ذكر حال من ترك حث غيره على الإطعام بأنه ممن يكذب بالدين فما بالنا بمن ترك هو الإطعام مع القدرة عليه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the surah, the one who does not encourage. So what about the one who does not give and he has the ability to do so? Al-Imam al-Zamakhshari رحمه الله says, جعل علامة التكذيب بالجزاء منع المعروف والإقدام عليه وإيذاء الضعيف. يعني لو أنه آمن بالجزاء وأيقن بالوعيد لخشي الله وتعالى وعقابه ولم يقدم على ذلك فحين أقدم عليه علم أنه مكذب. الزمخشري رحمه الله says in this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the sign of denying the day of judgment is not to give out to the people and to harm the weak ones like the orphans and the poor. This is a sign for the ones who do not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last day. Those who harm the poor and the needy and the weak people, and those who do not give or encourage others to give, these are the signs of being evil. And also, if you really believed in the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah and the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will never prevent the poor and the needy and the orphans from what you have, because what we have is given to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after saying this to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, have you seen the one who denies the final judgment? That is the one who repulses the orphan and does not encourage the feeling of the poor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ. And this is an ayah that has a great danger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, woe to those who pray. So some people may take this ayah and say, oh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish the people who pray. No, the Quran has to be taken in context. We cannot take the ayah away and say, Allah says in the Quran, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ. So why we pray? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying woe, and woe means a place in Jahannam for those who pray. We have to continue and complete the ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. So this woe for for those ones who pray that they are unmindful of their prayers. Sahoon, they do not come up with the salah. We will know from Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu the meaning of this ayah. قال ابن عباس الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون أي المنافقين الذين يصلون في العلانية حينما يراهم الناس ولا يصلون في السر إذا كانوا بعيدا عن الناس. ابن عباس said, this ayah is revealed regarding the hypocrites, those who pray when people can see them and they don't pray when they are by themselves. For example, if they are at home, they do not care about Salah. But when they go to the masjid, they pray in the first line behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they make sure everybody can see them, because they are coming to show off. They are not coming for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this place in Jahannam is for those hypocrites who come for Salah just to be seen, and when they are at home or another place away from the mu'mins, they do not even go to the Salah at all. أو هم المصلون الذين هم ساهون عن أداء الصلاة بالكلية. Or they are the ones who forget about their salah. Some Muslims, they just abandon the salah at all. They don't pray at all. So this ayah also is for them. Woe is for those Muslims who abandon their salah. أو هم الذين لا يأتون بها في الوقت المقدر لها شرعا فيخرجونها عن وقتها بالكلية كما قال مسروق وأبو الضحى. Or this ayah also can include those who do not pray on time, and they delay the salah without any excuse, and they pray it not in time. So they can be included in this ayah. They will be going to Jahannam when the Fajr is there, or the Asr is there, or the Dhuhr is there, Maghrib and Isha. The time comes, the Adhan is there, we have nothing to do, and then they forget about the salah, and then the preference goes away, the first time of the salah goes away, and then the middle time, and then the last time, and then they may just come after the second salah and they pray two salah with each other with no excuse. Those may be considered among those who will go to Jahannam because they delay their salah with no reason. أو ساهون عن الصلاة في وقتها الأول فدائما يؤخرونها لآخر الوقت بغير عذر أو ساهون عن أدائها بأركانها وشروطها على الوجه المأمور به. Or those who are unmindful of the salah, the conditions of the salah, and the khushu' in the salah. Khushu' is not also an option in our salah. It is a rukn. It is one of the pillars of our salah, is to be khashu', to focus, concentrate in the salah, to know what we are saying, to know what dua we are making. And it is a must to be a khashu'. يقول الله تعالى إن المنافقين يخادعون الله وهو خادعهم وإذا قاموا إلى الصلاة قاموا كسالى يراؤون الناس ولا يذكرون الله إلا قليلا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in this ayah what coincides with what Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه said. Surely المنافقون try to plan against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or deceive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is deceiving them. وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالًا. When they come to the salah, you see them coming to the salah lazy. They have no enthusiasm to come to the masjid and to pray for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are just coming to be seen. يُرَاءُونَ النَّاسِ. So they are coming showing off. وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. And they do not remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except like a little or a few times. So they come in just to show off. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ يُرَاءُونَ وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْمَاعُونَ. Those who only show off and refuse to give even the simplest aid. يُرَاءُونَ النَّاسَ بِصَلَاتِهِمْ وَلَيْسَ رَغْبَةً فِي الثَّوَابِ وَلَا رَهْبَةً بِالْعِقَابِ. They just come to the salah to show off so people can see them, and they are not afraid of the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, neither they are waiting for the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِنَّمَا يُصَلُّونَ حَتَّى يَرَاهُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ فَيَحْسَبُونَهُمْ مِنْهُمْ فَيَكُفُّوا عَنْهُمْ. The munafiqeen, by the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hypocrites, They just go to the masjid to show off, so the Muslims will see them praying, so the Muslims do not consider them their enemies. They consider them their brothers in Islam, and they shouldn't plan anything against them. So their plan just to be considered among the Mu'mins, they just go for Salah and show off in Salah. وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْمَاعُونَ And they prevent the simplest aid. هو إعارة ما ينتفع به ويستعان به. So they don't give anything to anyone who asks anything to help. أي لم يحسنوا عبادتهم لله سبحانه وتعالى فتركوا الصلاة ولم يحسنوا إلى خلقه حتى ولو بإعارة ما ينتفع به مع بقاء عينه ورجوعه إليهم بغضا لهم. They did not do anything good in ibadatullah. When they come to the salah, they just come to show off, and they did not also behave good with the people whenever they are asking for something to lend it or to give it out for people to help. They will never give it out, and they know that it will come back to them, but they don't give it out, hating those Muslims, and they don't want to give them any aid. قيل also الماعون هو الزكاة أو الصدقة كل ما ينتفع به كالقدر والدلو وغيره أو كل معروف أو أي شيء من متاع البيت. الماعون, this is the name of the surah, the simplest aid. The ulama said it can be anything. It can be zakah, it can be sadaqah, and also it can be anything in your household, in the house, like even a cooking pot. You have a pot that you cook, and somebody comes to borrow it, and you say, no, we don't have it, and you have it. Or you have like a bucket of water that you use, and some people are asking for that bucket of water, and you say, no. So this also considered al-ma'un. Or any good thing, any ma'roof, أو أي شيء من متاع البيت. If somebody is coming to ask you for anything, to lend it to him or her, and you say no, we will be going in the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because we will not believe in Allah and the last day until we make our salah in a good way, focus in our salah, and also we give to the poor, and we help the orphan, and also we do not show off in our ibadat and mu'amalat. When we do something, we never do it for the people, we just do it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we are asked for something that we have, anything small or big, that we can lend it out to people and it will come back to us, we should give it out, because this is from the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is from the deen of Islam. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us from what we heard tonight. I ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our deeds. I ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to be among those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed. And I ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among the mu'mins who will drink from the river of Al-Kawthar inshallah on the day of Yawm Al-Qiyamah. رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا إِسْرَافَنَا فِي أَمْرِنَا ثَبِّتْ عَلَى الْحَقِّ أَقْدَامَنَا انصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا في الإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا. ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولكل من له حق علينا يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وجزاكم الله خيرا.